Morning students, let us start today's lesson on the topic some basic concepts of chemistry. So today we are going to discuss about the properties of matter and their measurement, that is physical quantities and their SI units, measurement of temperature, volume, mass, weight and density, derived units and subsidiary units. So let us begin. So first of all, every substance has definite physical and chemical properties. Physical properties are those which can be measured or observed without changing the identity or composition of the substance. Example, mass, volume, density, melting point, boiling point, etc. Chemical properties are those in which a chemical change in the substance occurs. Many physical properties of the substance are quantitative in nature, means having some volume. Such properties are therefore called physical quantities, as explained now. So, in everyday life, we come across a number of measurements. Examples, suppose we buy vegetables in kilograms, milk in liters, cloth in meters, etc. So, however, during scientific studies, in addition to the measurements of mass, volumes, and lengths, we come across the measurement of a number of other quantities such as temperature, pressure, concentration, force, work, density, etc. So all such quantities which we came across during our scientific studies are called physical quantity. Evidently, the measurement of any physical quantity consists of two parts, the number and the unit. For example, if an object weighs 4.5 kg, it involves two parts. That is, first one is 4.5, that is the number, and kg, that is the unit. Thus, the main aims of this section are to see how accurately or precisely the number has been expressed. That is, concept of significant figures. And the second one is to study the units of measurement, that is the SI units. Third one is to derive the units of any physical quantity and to check the accuracy of any scientific equation by seeing that the dimensions of both sides of the equation are same. Okay, so let us proceed for SI unit. We have used one term, SI unit. So a unit is defined as the standard of reference chosen to measure any physical quantity is known as SI unit. Since early times, different types of units of measurements have been very popular in different parts of the world. Example, pounds for mass, miles, yards for distances. However, these units are quite cumbersome because of no uniformity in the conversion factors involved. Example, 1 mile will be equals to 1760, that is 1760 yards. That is, if we are considering 1 yard is equals to 3 feet and 1 foot is equals to 12 inches. So, now, in view of the difficulties mentioned above, French Academy of Science in 1791 introduced a new system of measurements called metric system, in which the different units of a physical quantity are related to each other as multiples of powers of 10. Example, suppose we have to write 1 kilometer, then we can write 10 to the power 3 meter. 1 centimeter, then it can be written as 10 to the power minus 2 meter, etc. So this system was found to be so convenient that scientists all over the world immediately adopted the system for reporting scientific data, and gradually most of the countries have also switched over to the system for measurements of everyday use. India also started following metric system since 1957. So the metric system as put forward earlier was further improved by the General Conference of Weights and Measures, which met in October 1960 in France. The improved system of units has been accepted internationally and is called International System of Units, or in short, we can say it SI units, or in French, it is also known as Systeme Internationale. So let us proceed further. So these are the seven basic physical quantities and their SI unit. So first one is mass. Mass having symbol M, and its SI unit will be kilogram, having symbol kg. Second is length, symbol L, SI unit will be meter. Third one, time, its SI unit is second. Fourth one, current, its symbol is I, and SI unit is ampere. Next one, temperature, its SI unit is Kelvin. Amount of substance, SI unit is mole. Luminous intensity, SI unit is candela. So these are the seven basic physical quantities. So now, derived units. So what are derived units? The unit of all other physical quantities are derived out of those of the basic physical quantities. The units thus obtained are called the derived units. Like suppose you can take example, you can see over here area, it is also a derived unit. Its formula is length square. So it is basically derived from the basic quantity, that is length. So it unit will be SI unit will be meter square. So next is velocity. Velocity you are knowing distance by time. So distance is length and time is another physical quantity. So its unit will be meter per second. Similarly, acceleration. Acceleration, it's also derived from the basic quantity, that is length and time, and its unit will be meter per second square. Now coming towards force. Force, you are knowing force is equals to mass into acceleration. So acceleration, just now we have discussed, it is derived from length and time, and we are multiplying mass over here. So mass, length and time. So its unit is kg meter per second square. We can also call it Newton. So similarly for density and work, these are also all known as derived quantity. There are many more derived quantities which are commonly used. So these are some of the commonly used physical quantities and their derived units. Most of the quantities you can see over here you will use later on in your physics, like surface tension, moment of force, that is torque, electric charge, current density, magnetic induction, moment of inertia, momentum, angular acceleration. All these physical quantity you will going to use in your physics. So subsidiary units. So what are subsidiary units? In most systems of units, a single unit is defined as a base unit for the description of a specified quantity. Other units are then defined as fractions, and multiples of this base unit, these are called subsidiary units. For example, in the United States, customary system of length is unit, the yard is the base unit. So note, you can ultimately say that subsidiary units are the metric units of power of 10. Quite often we require units that may be the multiples or fractions of the base unit. So the SI system recommends the multiples such as 10 to the power 3, 10 to the power 6, 10 to the power 9, etc. And fractions such as 10 to the power minus 3, 10 to the power minus 6, 10 to the power minus 9, etc. That is, the powers are the multiples of 3. So these are indicated by special prefixes. So you can see over here some of the prefixes which comes under subsidiary units, like deca, 10 to the power 1, kilo, 10 to the power 3, giga, 10 to the power 9, peta, 10 to the power 15. You can also see the fractions like centi, 10 to the power minus 2, micro, 10 to the power minus 6, pico, 10 to the power minus 12, like these. So these are some of the prefixes. So this is all about subsidiary units. So all of you must be knowing about the measurement of these physical quantities. So the system of units, including unit definitions, keep on changing with time. Whenever the accuracy of measurement of a particular unit was enhanced substantially by adopting new principles, member nations of meter treaty signed in 1857 agreed to change the formal definition of that unit. Each modern industrialized country, including India, has a National Metrology Institute, that is NMI, which maintains standards of measurement. This responsibility has been given to the NPL, that is National Physical Laboratory, situated in New Delhi. This laboratory establishes experiments to realize the base units and derived units of measurements and maintains national standards of measurement. These standards are periodically intercompared with standards maintained at other national metrology institutes in the world, as well as those established at the International Bureau of Standards in Paris. So moving towards the measurement of temperature. So there are three scales of temperature: degree Celsius, degree Fahrenheit, Kelvin. So though the SI unit of temperature is Kelvin, yet it is very common to express temperatures in degree Celsius. So these two are related to each other, as temperature in degree Kelvin will be equals to temperature in degree Celsius plus 273.15. We can also write, for simple calculation, temperature in degree Kelvin will be equals to degree Celsius plus 273. So however, it may be remembered that size of 1 Kelvin will be equals to size of 1 degree Celsius. So on the Celsius scale, freezing point of water is taken as 0 degree and boiling point of water is taken as 100 degree Celsius at normal atmospheric pressure. The scale is thus divided into 100 equal parts, each part representing 1 degree Celsius. Now on the Fahrenheit scale, freezing point of water is taken as 32 degree Fahrenheit and boiling point of water as 212 degree Fahrenheit. And the scale is divided into 180 equal parts. So 100 Celsius degrees will be equals to 180 Fahrenheit degrees, or 5 Celsius degrees will be equals to 9 Fahrenheit degrees. So degree Celsius is related to degree Fahrenheit, as degree Celsius will be equals to 5 by 9 degree Fahrenheit minus 32, or we can write degree Fahrenheit will be equals to 9 by 5 degree Celsius plus 32. So now moving towards measurement of volume. Volume has the units of length cube. Thus the SI unit of volume is meter cube. However, in the laboratory, generally smaller volumes are used. These are expressed in terms of centimeter cube, or milliliter, or decimeter cube, or liters. So these are related as follows: 1 liter will be equals to 1000 milliliter, which will be equals to 1000 centimeter cube, which is equals to 1 decimeter cube. 1 meter cube is equals to 100 to the power 3 centimeter cube. That is equals to 10 to the power 6 centimeter cube. Or we can write 10 to the power 3 decimeter cube. Or we can write 1000 liters. So this is the interrelations of the measurement of volumes. So you can see over here some volume measuring devices that are used in the chemistry laboratory, that is burette, pipette, graduated cylinder and volumetric flask. So now measurement of mass and weight. It is very important to understand that the term weight should not be confused in place of mass. They have different meanings. Mass is the quantity of matter contained in the sample, and for the given sample it is constant and does not depend upon the place, while weight is the force with which the body is attracted towards the earth. That is, we can write W, weight is equals to m into g. G is the acceleration due to gravity. So thus weight depends upon the acceleration due to gravity, which varies from place to place. So the mass of the substance can be determined very accurately in the laboratory using an analytical balance. So you can see over here, the first picture is of analytical balance, which is used in the laboratory previously. Now we are switching over to analytical balance, which is giving us accurate measurement, that is being used by the use of electricity. Those are also known as electrical balances, the second one and the third one. So now after measuring volume and mass, we can determine the density of any substance. So density of a substance, you are knowing, is the amount of mass per unit volume. So what will be the SI unit of density? We can write it as kg per meter cube. This unit is quite large, and a chemist often expresses density in gram per centimeter cube, where mass is expressed in grams and volume is expressed in centimeter cube. And in kg per meter cube, mass is expressed in kg and volume is expressed in meter cube. So this is all about measurement of physical quantities. So today we have learnt about the 7 basic physical quantities and their SI units: measurement of temperature, volume, mass, weight and density, some derived units and subsidiary units. Thank you, students.